Good day, everyone. Welcome to Music 7 Quarter 3. Today, we will be discussing about the musical instruments of Mindanao. Specifically, we are going to identify the musical instruments in Mindanao according to their classification. But before that, let's have a recap of the Hornbostel Sachs classification of musical instrument. Instruments are classified using 5 different categories depending on the manner in which the instrument creates the sound: idiophones, membranophones, chordophones, aerophones, and electrophones. So let's now proceed to the musical instruments of Mindanao. The first instrument that we have is the kulintang. It is a set of 8 knobbed gongs in graduated sizes from largest to smallest, mounted in a wooden frame, about a meter long. The kulintang is played by striking the gongs with 2 pieces of wood about 12 inches long while the player squats on the floor. Let's watch a video of how the kulintang is being played.
The kulintang is a set of 8 post gongs in graduated sizes arranged from lowest to highest and laid over a wooden frame. The kulintang is part of an instrumental ensemble along with other gongs and a skin drum. These instruments are common among the Mindanao region of Southern Philippines. This region contains different styles of kulintang playing. But in this video, I will only focus on the Maguindanao style. The kulintang is played by striking the knob of the gong with wooden sticks.
Next is gabang. This is a native xylophone in Sulu, a bamboo keyboard of different lengths on top constructed out of wood, with one end wider than the other. It is played by striking the wooden bars with a wooden hammer. Now let's watch a video of how a gabang is being played. The next instrument is the agung. It is a set of 2 wide-rimmed post gongs hung from horizontal pole or wooden frame. The larger lower-pitched gong of the 2 is called the pangandungan. The smaller higher-pitched gong, the thicker of the 2, is called the paninteken. The mallets, called balu, are made from short sticks about 1/2 foot in length and padded with soft but tough material such as rubber at one end. Next is the gandingan. It is a set of 4 small narrow-rimmed and suspended gongs. They hang in pairs with the knobs of the lower pitch gongs facing each other. The player usually a woman who stands between the 2 pair of gongs. Her body touches slightly the gong in the middle to prevent from swinging. Bobandil is a single, narrow-rimmed Philippine gong used primarily as the timekeeper of the Maguindanao Kulintang ensemble. It is struck with thin bamboo sticks to produce a metallic sound. There are 3 ways to play the bobandil. First is by striking the rim of the suspended gong with a pair of sticks on the left hand. Second, by striking the gong's rim with the right hand using 1 stick while the left hand grasps the rim. And third, by laying the instruments upside and striking the gong's rim with the 2 sticks. Next is the kagul. It is a type of Philippine bamboo scraper gong or slit drum of the Maguindanaoan and Visayans with a jug edged on one side, played with 2 beaters, one scraping the jugged edge and the other one making a beat. The Maguindanaoan Use it in the rice paddies to guard against voracious birds, using the sound it produces to scare them away. The Maguindanaon and the Bukidnon folks also use it for simple dance rhythms during social occasions. Lastly, kubing. It is a bamboo jaw harp of Tiruray. These have become one of the most popular jaw harps internationally due to their highly responsive sound and ornate designs. In the hands of a good player, the kubing is capable of vast number of sounds and timbres. Let's now proceed to the chordophones or the stringed instruments. First, we have the kujapi. It is a two-stringed black lute instrument in Maguindanao that is made of wood which resembles an elongated guitar, usually having two strings. It varies in sizes, but normally, it is about 1.5 meters long. Next instrument is the sirunga gandhi, a guitar-like made of bamboo, cut before one node and after next. Two cords are slit loose side by side from the outer skin fibers of the bamboo itself, and these are given tension by means of bridges. Saluroy, it is a polychordal tube zither of bagobo. It has 6 parallel strings running through the bamboo tube. The tube which is the body serves as the resonator, and it can be a whole tube or a half tube, with both ends enclosed by a bamboo nodes. And lastly, under chordophones is the aduwag-ay. It is a one-stringed fiddle instrument of Bilaans, also called kugot in Agusan Manobo and duwagi in Tibuli. Let's now proceed to the aerophones or the wind instruments. First, we have the sahunay, a bamboo flute leaving 6 holes for the fingers and trumpet made of coconut leaf. It is about 50 centimeters long and 3 centimeters in diameter. This is a bamboo flute of the Tausug in Sulu. Palendag is a lip valley flute considered to be the toughest of the 3 bamboo flutes to use because of the way one must shape one slips against its tip to make a sound. And last instruments under aerophones is the suling. It is made mainly of tamyang bamboo, a long, thin-walled bamboo tube. The mouthpiece of the suling is circled with a thin band made of rattan near a small hole. We are now down to the membranophones or the drum instruments. First is the dabakan. It is also called as dadabuan in Maranao. It is a goblet-shaped drum of Maguindanao and Maranao, which has a single head covered with goat, lizard, or snake skin, but the membrane could also be made of carabao skin. Distract with 2 thin bamboo stakes about 18 inches in length. And finally, gandang. It is a two-headed cylindrical drum of Tausug, Samal, Bajau, Maranao, and Maguindanao. It is also called as kendang in other Southeast Asian countries, and it is one of the primary instruments in the gamelan ensembles of Java, Bali, and Terengganu. Musical ensembles are groups of musicians performing instrumental music together. There are 2 musical ensembles from Mindanao. First is the Kulintang Ensemble, and second, the Bamboo Ensemble. The kulintang ensemble have varied functions but are mostly used for celebrations, rituals, and are mainly divided into two types. Number one is the kulintangan, manobo kotabato or kwintangan, and number two, tahunggu, agung, salmagi, blowon, simagi. Bamboo ensemble. Bamboo is considered among early Filipinos as a spiritual connection from our physical world to the spiritual. Many bamboo instruments were made for this purpose, while some were also used for entertainment and personal expressions. Some common instruments are the gabang and the sirunggagandhi. Solo instruments means alone literally. Henceforth, a solo instrument can be performed alone or supported by an accompanying instrument or set of instruments. Some common instruments are the kujapi and the suling. Thank you for watching! I hope you have learned something today. Goodbye, class!